Green growth is a fundamental aspect for companies today. Trading across borders, doing business across borders, it's no longer possible to not factor in environmental aspects or environmental opportunities. If we look at society right now, if we look at the environmental challenges we face, whether climate change, water, biodiversity, companies cannot operate in a society that is failing. So simply put, you cannot be in business if you're not dealing with green growth. The reason these processes are important is that they provide a seminal moment, a moment where the world can come together and assess what has been progress that has been done to date and what still remains to be done. The private sector, as we just mentioned, is an integral part of all of these challenges, and coming together with government, civil society, and others is fundamental, and this is what Rio and others, G20 and others, provide. Now, when you look at Rio+20 particularly, it's a very important moment because you're building on what was established in 1992 at the first Rio Earth Summit. And we're now 20 years past that, and we have many of the same challenges. In fact, many of them have actually gotten worse. ICC has been playing a role leading business, global business input into these processes like the G20, like Rio+20 for many years. We were the main business organization bringing companies to interact with the process in 1992. We also did as well in the 2002 World Summit for Sustainable Development in Johannesburg. And once again, at Rio, ICC, working with partners, will be bringing together a wide variety of business voices, large and small, from all over the world, to try to find challenges to promote green growth and to eventually arrive at a green economy. And the ICC was founded in 1919 on the basis of promoting open trade and investment across borders as a way to remedy the challenge of international war and international conflict. This is the same for environmental issues. There is no way you can achieve a green economy or green growth without working through open trade and investment frameworks. Let me give you an example of what I mean. One of the key ways to deal with some of the environmental challenges we have today, such as climate change, water, et cetera, is to promote the development and deployment of new and innovative technologies. The only way to do this is through global trade and global trade. And for example, open multilateral trade liberalization is a conduit to promote technology dissemination and diffusion. So as we look at where we have some of these fundamental environmental challenges in the emerging world, in countries like China or in India or South Africa, it is fundamental to have this conduit of trade so that the economy can both grow and grow in the right way, which is the green way. I think there's three points. I think the first is that business has to be at the table in terms of global macroeconomic policy making in this area. I think the second is the role of technology development and diffusion, which is the point on trade that I made earlier. And the third is the need for improved investment regulatory regimes in many countries. And I think these are the three key points that ICC is looking to bring together, both at a national level, with working with governments, as well as international level at the G20 or at Rio+20.